We are undergraduate students, and our title is geophysical time series versus financial time series of agricultural products, similarities and differences. We chose prices, soybeans and corns received by producers in the USA, because USA is the largest producer of this commodity, and future contracts received from Chicago Board of Trade. The financial time series and monthly averages. Weather time series, we divided the production area into cells and chose five representative stations of each cell, and the data set contains the daily time series of rainfall and the maximum temperature. We calculated monthly rainfall and monthly average monthly maximum temperature, and we wanted to find similarities and differences between financial time series and geophysical time series.
Well, there are some conclusions we want to take up. Just for the beginning, here on the louder. The L ratios plots here show us that there are different statistical properties of the model distribution of the commodity prices with the rainfall and the temperature. Also here there is an obvious seasonality and for prices, for both prices, soybean and corn. And of course of the temperature and for the rainfall. Here we see that there is a strong autocorrelation structure of the commodity prices for both corn and soybean, which is not the case for the rainfall and temperature without the autocorrelation structure not being strong. We see that the cross-correlation between commodity prices, the rainfall and the temperature is very weak, but there is a strong cross-correlation between the prices and the future contracts.
Okay, very good.